Hold on here.
I'm over here in the northern Negev, and we're standing here in a wheat field. And one of the things we were told is that they've harvested most of the wheat in Israel. By the end of the week, it'll all be harvested. And you know, here we come to this field, and it's cut. And so if you look here, though, you can see that when they cut it, they left all these stalks. So you open this up. Can you see it? And you see that, squeeze that. Look, the insides pop out. That's late milk, early worm stage. So it's actually not even ripe grain. So why did they harvest this field? Why did they cut this field in the northern Negev? And the answer is they cut it for silage. Ooh, milk stage, insides pop out. So you couldn't, you know, you couldn't produce this into flour. This is not ripe grain. This cannot be brought as a wave sheaf offering. This is not, you know, in the wave sheaf offering, it talks about Leviticus 23 verse 10. It says, when you come to the land to harvest its harvest, you'll bring the first sheaf of the harvest. This isn't harvest. This is pre-harvest. It's being cut for silage to feed to cows.
So what does that tell you?
That tells me that Shavuot is way off. This field is simply not at harvest stage yet. So one of the things we've been told is that, you know, 30% of the fields, this was a day or two ago, 30% of the fields in Israel have been harvested. And by the end of the week, they'll be all done. And this is the first one we found that actually has been cut in the northern Negev, but it's been cut for silage. We have not found a single harvested field that was harvested for grain, that where the grain was fully ripe.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're in the northwestern Negev, and we are looking at huge fields of wheat out here that have been cut. It's real dry out here. Take a look at this. Now, let's get Nehemiah on here to talk a little bit about this whole thing with the wheat.
So
and
one of the
what we're looking at here.
One of the things that's been going around is that they have harvested all the grain in Israel and it's time for Shavuot, and today is March 31st. So I came down here to look if that's actually the case. And what I find is they have cut these wheat fields, however, they haven't harvested them. This isn't harvest ripe grain. What you have is these rows of cut wheat, and normally if you have a combine involved, what the combine will do is it'll extract the head, and from the head it'll extract the seed. When we look down here at these rows of the grain, what you find is the heads are still here, and when we open it up, we find out the grain isn't even harvest ripe. Let's have a look at that. Okay, open this little guy up. Look, that seed is still forming. When you squeeze it, the insides pop out. That's what
let's squeeze another one. Go ahead.
Squeeze another
from
one.
From the middle. Do it nice and slow here.
Okay. This is what we would call the worm stage. It's even sort of at the end of the milk stage, beginning of the worm stage. See that? Kind of little insides pop out.
Right.
Still milk stage, beginning worm stage. So this is not ripe grain that's been cut. It's been cut for silage.
Uh-huh.
They feed that to cows.
We're out here off of road 232, not very far from Gaza. And this is near a place called Nir Yitzhak. Nir Yitzhak. You can look it up on a map.
If you open up, the head is still on the stalk.
All right, let me get closer to this. Hold on here.
The head is still on the stalk, and then inside here, we have essentially, I mean, this one's actually completely empty. I guess because it's been left here to dry. Look at that.
Perfect.
That's still milk stage, beginning of worm stage. What we have yet to see anywhere in the northern Negev is a wheat field that's been cut for grain. And at the time of the Feast of Unleavened Bread, that's when you want to have the beginning of the barley harvest. And the barley ripens before the wheat, but it definitely is, even for wheat, it's not anywhere near Aviv, and it's definitely not anywhere near being harvest ripe, even though it's been cut for silage.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, here we are again, out here in the fields, not far from Sufa, S-U-F-A. In Kassam Alley. There you are.
How you guys doing over there?
Yeah.
Up here we can actually see the balloon, which is monitoring the things that are going in Gaza, less than a mile away from here. We're right on the border. This is where they lob the Kassams over. So we probably don't want to spend too much time here. But because these reports have been going around telling people that all of the grain in Israel has been harvested, we came to actually look for ourselves. If you can come a little bit closer.
Yeah.
You got this?
Okay, go ahead.
And here is a head of grain, right? When you harvest with a combine, the head is cut off, and then it's crushed up, moved around like this until they remove the seed.
Yeah.
Well, why didn't they do this with this hay? Because it's not harvest ripe. You can't do it with unharvest ripe grain. And in this particular grain, if we open up and look at the seed, what we're going to find is it's tiny. If you can even see that, it's in the really early stage of ripening. This was probably cut quite a long time ago, and before the seed had a chance to form, and now what little of the seed had formed is completely dried out. So these are empty heads. So we're here in the fields near Be'eri, which is a place in the northern Negev, not far from Gaza. And we're here with the gentleman whose machine is scooping up this this grain that's been cut, this wheat. Mm-hmm. And he was just telling me a minute ago about what's going on here. אז אתה אמרת שבעצם באתם ממקצרה וקיצרתם את חיטה.
יש מקצרה פה, אתם יכולים לראות
אותה. Okay. He said there's a mower here that came and mowed the grain. אז למה אתם בעצם לא מחכים להוציא את הגרעין? So I asked him, why is it that you're not waiting till the grain is riper that you can extract the seed? So this year there was a drought.
Mm-hmm.
And there wasn't enough rain in the Negev and really in all of Israel.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And he said, therefore it didn't get to the stage where there's a seed from which you can produce flour. So what do you as ma atem osim im im hita hazot?
Hita hazot anachnu kotzrim ve'achshav ve'notnim ota ke'ochel le'parot.
He says now we are harvesting it and we're giving it as food to cows. Ve'ma amarta she hamiktzoa shelcha?
Ani raftan.
And he says he's a raftan, which is somebody who has cows. He's a I guess a cow herd.
Okay.
ואם הייתם משאירים את זה בשדה, באיזשהו שלב זה היה מגיע לגרעין? אולי גרעין קטנטן?
משהו קטן, אבל זה לא...
לא שווה. Okay, so this is a very interesting thing. He said if he had left it in the fields, it would produce a very tiny seed and it isn't economically worth it for them. But if they did that, he said that the time that they would harvest it would be May and early June.
Okay, now show me that grain, Avi.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see what that grain he just cut.
Yep.
Right, what does it look like?
Okay, ready? Look at this.
Okay, they're gonna feed it to the cows, he said.
Yeah, that's...
The cowherd told us he's gonna feed it to the cows.
I'm gonna do it! This is a bad idea, I shouldn't do this, should I?
Well, go ahead and try it. Why not?
Okay.
Here we go.
If I miss the bale of hay, it's over.
Here we go.
Okay, I've always wanted to do this.
All right, hang
Woo!
On.